In this section, we will cover the third mandatory check, that is known as the buckling analysis check. In the buckling analysis check, the stresses are dominantly, so the dominant stresses are compressive. Now, this situation easily occurs in the case of vessel under external pressure, but it can also occur in vessel under internal pressure. So near to the discontinuities, the dominant stresses could be compressive, and there are chances of local buckling occurring, typically at the crown to knuckle junction of torus felcher head of a pressure vessel can fail under buckling under internal pressure. However, most of the cases you will be looking into external pressure loading for doing this analysis. The buckling analysis can be performed using three alternative approaches. The first one is elastic buckling, the second is elastic plastic, and the last one is a particular variation of elastic plastic analysis known as collapse analysis. The elastic buckling analysis, as the name suggests, uses the perfectly elastic material model. Elastic plastic uses the elastic plastic model. And the last one, in addition to elastic plastic model, considers the geometric inaccuracies which can exist in the model. In this section, we'll be covering the elastic buckling analysis. We will illustrate the approach by using an actual case. So we are considering a cylindrical vessel subjected to external pressure of 0.10135 MPa. The dimensions of the vessel are as given here. The first step is to create the geometric model. So in this case, the geometric model is created using surface geometry rather than actual three-dimensional geometry. So this will allow us to use the surface elements or two-dimensional elements, which will make the computational solution time much smaller. The next step is to create the finite element mesh. The mesh should be of sufficient discretization size so that the proper results are obtained. The actual details of buckling analysis are not covered in this session. However, to just summarize, the first step is what is known as the preload state, in which the model is subjected to the design pressure load. So in this case, the external pressure is applied on the model with proper boundary conditions, and the initial deformation of the model is obtained. So this is used for the subsequent step, which is known as eigenvalue analysis, to determine the buckling load. The next is to create the buckling step. Please note that this particular analysis is carried out under Abaqus software, so the interface screens are corresponding to that software. You have to mention how many eigenvalues which corresponds to the different buckling shapes which you are interested in. So in this case, the three eigenvalues have been mentioned in the design, and you have to apply what is known as perturbation load to the actual boundary condition which is applied earlier. Under this perturbation load, you will get the different buckling mode shapes and their corresponding eigenvalues. So the first buckling mode corresponds to formation of two lobes. The second buckling mode is identical to the first mode, except that the orientation of the lobes is different. And the third mode is having three number of lobes. The value of the buckling pressure is obtained by using the first mode, or the lowest eigenvalue mode. The buckling load can be calculated using the preload, which is the design pressure what we have considered, and the eigenvalue times the perturbation load, which is used for the eigenvalue analysis. So in our case, the buckling pressure is computed as 0.9263 MPa. So this is the pressure which the finite element analysis prescribes. It predicts that the buckling will occur at this particular pressure. This pressure needs to be compared with the factored design pressure. So you have to calculate the design factor, and using that you can calculate the factored design pressure, which is 0.253 MPa. Since our buckling pressure is higher than the factored design pressure, the buckling, the particular geometry is safe against the given external design pressure. So this overall summarizes how the elastic buckling analysis can be done. In the elastic plastic buckling analysis, you will be using elastic plastic material, and some more adjustments and changes in design factors are involved.